change in matter. The objective of the video is to understand the process of crystallization, the process of rusting.
Children, in the previous video, you have learnt about the chemical changes and the examples associated with it. Chemical changes are permanent and physical changes are temporary. In this video, we will learn about the process of crystallization and rusting of iron. Let us then go back to Rama and Babu and know about these two processes.
Babu, we did a lot of work in our school. Some students in our class are participating in the science exhibition. We have to show an experiment. I am wondering, what experiment should I show?
Experiment? I suddenly remembered something. Didi, today in our science class, the teacher told us about crystallization. He also showed us an example.
Remember, I had told you about two kinds of changes?
Yes, Didi. I know that crystallization is a physical change. Today, our science teacher had explained.
Babu, what experiment did the teacher show you?
Today, the teacher mixed the salt in boiling water and cooled it in a jar. Then, he tied a thread to a small stick and placed it in the jar. Then he said that the salt crystals will deposit on that thread in 2 to 3 days.
Do you know why crystallization is useful and why is it a physical change?
Didi, the teacher explained that crystallization is a technique through which crystals are formed either through natural or artificial method. In this process, the substance's liquid state converts to solid form. The solid form produced by this technique has crystalline structure. Crystallization is used to purify impure solid substances. This is a physical change because matter can easily come back to its original form.
Yes, you rightly said it. Another example of crystallization is the purification of salt. The purification of impure salt crystals in the sea water to salt is done by crystallization, and salt gets converted into larger crystals.
Oh, I see.
Can you all think of another crystallization process which is beneficial to the humans?
How much we can learn from science?
You are right, Didi. What is this? Why are these workers removing this hand pump from here? Come on, let's find out.
Sir, why are you removing this hand pump from here?
This hand pump is rusty. It is now unusable. There is no water coming out from it. Another hand pump will have to be installed.
Is it? What is rust, Didi? I have some knowledge about this, but I would like to know more.
Look, can you see a brown layer here? It is called rust. Because of this, the pump got spoiled.
Yes, I can see it. I even saw such a layer on the iron door of our house. But why did Father not remove the gate?
Babu, let's talk while walking towards the house. I will tell you about this process.
Okay, Didi.
Babu, a few days ago, I explained to you about chemical changes. Do you remember?
Yes, I remember, Didi. You said that this change is permanent. It cannot be reversed, and after the chemical change, a new substance is formed.
Wow, you remember everything. Rusting is also an unusable chemical change. When we keep an iron object in the open, the brown layer solidifies, which is called rust. It spoils the iron items.
Didi, we have come home.
You sit here. I will explain by writing in a paper. All changes require certain conditions.
Didi, how does rusting take place?
Humidity is required in the air for rusting. Iron consisting of oxygen and air present in the air undergoes a chemical change that causes rusting. Iron atoms, the smallest substance of an object, react with water and oxygen, creating a new substance called iron oxide. In common usage, iron oxide is rust.
If iron gets spoiled due to rust, then there is a lot of loss, isn't it, Didi? Our doors, toys, tools, farm machines, all of them are made up of iron only, isn't it?
Why just toys? Other objects such as cars, buses, trucks, bridges, etc. are all made of iron.
It means that a lot of damage can be caused by rust.
You know, Babu, rusting can be prevented to a great extent.
How can this happen, Didi?
We can prevent the circumstances leading to a change. For example, we can apply a layer of paint on iron so that iron does not come in direct contact with air. We can paint iron things.
So, we should ask Father to get this iron gate painted.
Yes, that's why vehicles like cars, buses, etc. get painted.
The pipes in our house are also fine.
There is also a layer of substance on iron pipes and taps in the house.
A layer of zinc is put on me. This is called galvanization. Because of this, I don't get rusted.
Babu, our steel utensils are also made of iron.
But I have never seen rust on a steel vessel.
Steel is an alloy of iron, chromium and nickel. Due to this, it does not rust.
This means that iron can be protected from rusting.
There are other measures to prevent the formation of rust. They are very simple. We should keep our appliances dry, keep them away from water and paint iron items. By doing this, we can save our belongings from rusting. Even after drying the frozen water on our bikes, scooters, bicycles after the ride, these vehicles will not spoil quickly.
Thank you, Didi, for sharing so much important information.
Let's go inside the house.
Children, in this video, we learned about rusting and crystallization. See you soon.
Change. The objective of the video is to understand what a chemical change is. The examples related to chemical change. Children, in the previous video, you understood about the physical changes. No new substance is formed in a physical change. Just as we see physical change in our day-to-day life, we also see chemical changes. Let us go back to Rama and Babu and learn about chemical changes.
Mother, I'm very hungry. Give me roti quickly.
Okay. Go wash your hands. I will prepare the roti. Rama, you also come and eat.
I'm coming, Mother.
Didi, yesterday you were saying that unbaked bread can be made into flour. Atta again. and so it is a physical change. Mother is preparing the roti and it is now eatable. This does not look like a physical change to me.
See, now this roti is made. Can we change it to flour again?
No, Didi. We can only eat it now.
Rightly said. There are some changes that we cannot change. This change is permanent. Such changes are called chemical changes. Baking bread is a chemical change because no one can reverse it after baking the bread.
It means that the dough became a roti?
Yes. Due to chemical changes, a new substance is created. When we eat food, the stomach digests the food and breaks the food into smaller and simpler substances. Then energy is produced. So, the roti you ate has been completely transformed into another substance. This is the characteristic of a chemical change. At the end of the chemical change, a new substance is formed.
Can you tell if photosynthesis is a chemical change? If your answer is yes, what is the reason for this?
Babu, can you think of more examples?
Didi, yes. This curd is also the result of chemical change. Curd is made from milk, isn't it?
Very rightly said. You know, chemical changes lead to mass changes. If you have eaten your food, then come here. We will now light this candle with a matchstick. What do you see?
Didi, I see that the big candle has quickly become smaller.
It became small due to the burning, and this will get converted into carbon dioxide and a little steam which will go into the air.
Matchbox can burn coal, wood, etc. And these are all chemical changes. Am I correct, Didi?
Surprisingly, a small matchbox with very low energy burns a lot of heat and light energy when it burns wood or coal.
I remember now, Didi. Firecrackers we had bought for Deepavali when burned will result in a physical change.
Wow! Burning crackers is classified as a chemical change because after burning of crackers, heat energy, sound energy and light energy are produced. This change is irreversible and is also permanent.
The chemical changes look dangerous.
You know, Babu, on the other hand, some chemical changes are very useful. For example, due to chemical changes, by mixing many elements, medicines, soaps, etc. are made, which are quite beneficial for humans.
Oh, okay, Didi. Then, what are the side effects of chemical changes?
When food is spoiled due to chemical changes, it is an unwanted change. Due to this, the nutritious elements of food are destroyed and food is not edible. Burning explosion, food spoilage, color change and smell are all unwanted aspects of chemical changes.
Didi, you have explained all this to me so well. This information will help me in doing my homework.
Children, as you have seen, chemical changes are irreversible. Some are beneficial to mankind and some are harmful. We have learnt about various chemical changes today. In the next video, we shall learn about rusting and crystallization. See you soon!